You know, I think what I love most about it is just the sort of magic between what was already an amazing story and this incredible new technology that is literally delivering something that is jaw-dropping. For audiences now around the world to see this story brought to life with real fire-breathing dragons, I think is just going to be thrilling. Well, the thing that is so phenomenal about this show is that it's just the most extraordinary and, as you can see, really kind of mind-boggling technology bringing these creatures to life. And yet, at the heart of this show is still a great and very personal story. And I think the things that are most impressive, and we've seen it with audiences, is how much heart it has.
I think this is going to be one of the great opportunities for families to spend time together and be thrilled by the new immersive arena spectacular. This summer, bring your kids. It's one of the great opportunities for families to have a thrilling and exciting time together. This is absolutely the most spectacular show you'll ever see.
So we've got a kind of, you know, metro system in the sky with all these multiple pulleys, which has got hanging off it a dragon, which is, again, automated by an entirely different automation system to allow it to have the full scale of kind of realistic characterization and emotions. And then that's flying against an entire projected world. So you've got three very, very complicated animation systems which all have to marry, you know, as one, and then you place into it, I suppose, finally the most important part, you know, which is a human being. So that would be indicative all the way through, really, of how we are having a great time, both pushing the technologies to new limits and marrying them and doing it in a way that we feel is safe and deliverable in terms of getting the show open. For all, you know, all these new frontiers in terms of levels of spectacle, I hope what will wow the audience most. They can sit with 15,000 people and be told a whole story that really moves and touches them. And I think that's, you know, for all of the technologies, that's the, you know, going to be the heart of it.
We've got something like Red Death, which is the ultimate dragon. It's 12 meters long, 5 meters wide, 6 meters high. And that's just the head and the neck, and it's a lovely combination of what we physically build and then this use of the projection screen. And that, if you look on the inside of it, is serious engineering. Toothless, being such a demanding puppet, requires 4 puppeteers. So we have 3 what we call voodoo puppeteers who are controlling the gross body movements right down to small facial expression, and then actually on the puppet, or concealed within the puppet chassis, we have the driver. And so those 4 have to work seamlessly together.
To describe the show to start out, there's so many things in it. Everything from robotic dragons to things that are flying in the air, people, other dragons, there's running on walls, there's swimming underwater. It's all just, there's so much going on all at once. It's this amazing spectacle. And then on top of that, you have this brilliant story that was written by DreamWorks about the whole movie and this beautiful, like, bond between this dragon and his boy, or this boy and his dragon, and then his problems with his dad. And it's just all this drama and spectacle, like, all mixed together. It's incredible.
Honestly, to describe the show as a whole, like even in one word, it would just be spectacle. Like, it's amazing. It's there's just so many kind of features of the show that have never been seen in live performance before. So it's really something special and something new, you know, that is taken the theater industry by, you know, storm. It's amazing. I mean, we have automated flying dragons suspended, you know, 10 meters above the ground with full-on projection in the background, all coordinated to make it look like you're in this new world. Like, it's taking a new step in theater, I think.
It's spectacular. Even though I've seen it a billion times backstage, in front of stage, in the audience, I still find myself like hearing scenes and going, what's happening? And I'm still amazed at the things that every show I feel is different. There's something that, you know, Hiccup does different or I do different, and there's always different energies on the stage. And I think that makes it more exciting, is not having to do a show over and over and over again, doing the same lines over and over again, but rather having like different, feeding off one another's energy and making it unique to us and to the audience. So that makes it a lot more fun for me.
Everyone just motivates each other so much. There's never a dull moment. Everyone's always learning something or attempting something new. Everyone's just going for it all the time. And it is such a diverse group, such a variety of skills and talents. I've learned so much. Well, Astrid's a very feisty and determined girl. She knows that she's the best dragon trainer there. And she doesn't really have time to deal with anyone else, especially Hiccup, because he's just a nuisance to her.
So when it came to doing How to Train Your Dragon, we knew that those creatures had to interact, they had to show a lot more emotion, they had to help convey the humour of the piece and the real heart of the story. I think probably the best word I'd use to describe audience reaction is a sense of wonder. And really you see that transpire in their faces, the kids as the dragons fly past, they're sort of compelled to wave. And actually it's not just the kids that are compelled to wave, adults do. I find myself waving at Toothless every time he goes past.